Hey, Mike.
Hey, how are you, man? Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's good to meet you. Yeah. I appreciate you having me out. So, I mean, looking around, I'm seeing some awesome guns, a lot of areas to shoot out here. What all do you guys do here?
Yeah, well, welcome to the U.S. Shooting Academy. This is probably the premier training place in the U.S. They do everything from concealed carry to self-defense training to rifle, shotgun, handgun. They have a full set of competitive range. They hold the national matches here, so this is a great place to train, man.
So this is like the shooting man's Disneyland, is what you're telling me.
This is it, dude. If you want to shoot, this is the mecca. In Tulsa, Oklahoma, you got to come visit the range. It's freaking phenomenal. You can do anything you want on the range.
Okay, well, then I want to do everything. What am I going to get to do today?
Well, today, we can't quite do everything in one particular day, but sure. I know you know your background is air guns and you've been around that a lot with the show, but mm-hmm. today we're going to focus on some things you probably haven't done. That's self-defense related training with an airsoft and air gun. And one of the things that we do here at the U.S. Shooting Academy is we're a big believer in systematic training, meaning you can't always go out and live fire. And if you look at ammunition prices today, it's hard to get. A lot of people can't afford that, but you can use airsoft and air guns to supplement your training and really develop a high level of skill. So we're gonna talk about that, as well as using the air gun for self-defense, the pros and cons. Will it work, will it not work? We'll go from there.
Well, I've got minimal skills, so let's go, and I can't wait to see what you can teach me.
Sounds good to me, let's go, man.
All right, brother.
All right, Mike, so here we are, live fire range.
Yep.
Obviously, I've got a lot of knowledge here on air guns, airsoft guns, but this airsoft gun looks very similar to this gun. Talking about this.
Yeah, this bad boy is actually my JP rifle. This is my home defense rifle. This is a real firearm, live firing, obviously. Mm-hmm. This is something that I've set up for home defense if I were to need a home defense type rifle. And the thing is that I wanted to show you the similarities. If you're training with airsoft or, you know, air guns of any kind, there's probably one that's made that's identical or very similar to your live firearm, which, once again, because we're on the live fire range, doesn't necessarily mean we got to go live fire.
Right.
You know, we shot 100 rounds on this today, that'd be pretty expensive. We could shoot hundreds of BBs all day long and practice and work around cover and do a lot of different things with this gun and spend a few dollars.
Right.
You know, so.
And especially for someone, like you said, that is a very, like, this gun makes them uncomfortable.
Right.
But they want to get comfortable with the feeling of guns. You come to a gun like this.
The critical component in training, and I train literally hundreds of people a year, is comfort.
Mm-hmm.
And when I get a brand new shooter or a shooter that's just not comfortable picking up, you know, an M4 type system, they're loud. They don't recoil a lot, but they're loud. They can be scary. I can put an airsoft gun or an air gun in their hand and let them shoot it all day long, and they start to have fun. And one of the things about that is when people are having fun, man, they're learning. They're enjoying themselves.
Sure.
And, you know, that's the concept of using airsoft and training, air guns and training, because it increases the fun factor. You know, when we're talking about systematic training, we have dry fire, which is basically if I took any kind of firearm, it's unloaded, I draw it, and I can get that click. The next level is to use airsoft or air type guns. So I've actually got the BBs or the pellets going downrange, or the plastic BBs going downrange. Now I can actually affirm hits on the target. I know if what I'm doing is working, and I'm having fun with it too.
Right.
You know, people start shooting BBs, they smile and enjoy themselves.
So. Well, and that's what we're trying to get across here, is that guns can be fun.
Absolutely.
You know, if you're safe and you're doing them right and you're in the right environment, there's a lot of fun to be had.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, shooting is fun.
It's a blast.
You know, and safety's key, you know, like you said.
So talk to me, show me the similarities between these guns for someone. Like, I mean, I've never held or shot a gun, an M4 type gun. So I don't know the similarities.
Right. Well, for example, this is a 6mm BB airsoft gun.
Uh-huh.
It actually has a magazine that looks identical to a live magazine. So if we were to load it, it would look just like this.
Right
now, this is how the gun comes stock out of the box. So if I wanted to mimic my home defense gun, I'd simply, you know, maybe add an optic sight. This actually has sling mounts on it. It has a collapsible stock, so I can do all of the same things that I can with my live firearm. As a matter of fact, literally the stock on this particular gun, when I got it from Umarex, came exactly like the stock on my live gun. So when I'm practicing, you know, my cheek weld, or I'm working around cover and I'm doing different positions, which I like to practice, I can practice it with this gun all day long.
Okay.
You know, with a few different additions, you know, I could add a light to the gun if I wanted to, and I could also take this firearm with the right protective gear. And once again, we talked about safety, man. Safety is the key. I could clear my house and practice different things. Once again, you got to be careful of backstop, because these things zing the BBs out pretty quickly.
Right.
And I can work some skills that I can never work with this live fire firearm. To work this, you know, in a structured environment, walls or doors or whatever else, I've got to go to a shoot house. And how many people have access to a live fire shoot house?
Not many.
You know, what, do you show up in your local range and say, hey, can I go use your live fire shoot house?
Wives typically frown upon that.
Yeah, they do. It's not a good thing. So, and, You know, and if you look at the rest of the guns, man, I carry a Smith & Wesson M&P. So if I have, this is once again, you know, a CO2 pistol. This is exactly the same size as the carry gun that I carry. Mm-hmm. And what that does is it allows me to holster it up in my carry holster, and it fits just like my normal carry gun. So I could practice my draw process or techniques or whatever I want with this gun and once again spend pennies, do it very, very safely. Mm-hmm. I could shoot in my garage, you know, set up some sort of safe backstop and have lots of fun training. And, you know, the more I train, the more I learn how to access that firearm, the better I'm going to become. So if you take that particular system, you've got a safety. The first thing I would teach you about mounting a rifle and utilizing this rifle is where our thumb position is going to be. Our thumb position is going to be on top of the safety.
Right.
So if you notice, both of us have workable safeties, and that's the neat thing about these systems is everything on them works just like the live firearm. So the manipulations you do in training, the things you're trying to ingrain in your brain, and they're going to be exactly the same, you know, on the live fire and the other guns. So, you know, you get those good training repetitions and you're ingraining good habits.
And I'm assuming if you're dealing with a gun like this,
the
actual shooting process is a small portion of what you have to do to learn to maneuver, especially if you're doing like tactical stuff,
how
to, like you said, shooting around corners or loading or the correct holding position, all of that stuff comes in way before you're even actually shooting the gun, right?
Absolutely. I mean, when I talk about teaching someone to shoot, we're talking about manipulating the gun and marksmanship skills. So I can teach all of the manipulation skills, drawing it to clearing it to loading it pretty much with an airsoft type system. Mm-hmm. And then marksmanship, that's simply a matter of you learning where to either put the dot or the front and rear sight on the handgun or rifle that you're shooting. So we can teach all those skills with these weapon systems. And then when it comes to actually controlling live recoil, then you've got to shoot a live gun. But remember, systematically, dry fire to airsoft or BB type training to that live fire firearm, you add those three components together and you spend a lot less time on the live fire range and a lot less money on ammo.
Sure.
And you get as much or more skill.
So if you're a tremendous shooter, hunter, whether it be a law officer or military guy, and you're very comfortable with these guns, you can still get a lot out of this gun. Not only from that kind of guy, all the way down to the young kid who just wants to get comfortable, you know, the dad wants to take him hunting or take him out, get him comfortable with a gun in his hands, how to shoot, how to hold, or your wife or a family member, something like that. These guns are perfect.
They are, you know, and I fit the guy that's experienced. I mean, I shoot upwards of 30 to 40,000 live fire rounds a year. I mean, I shoot professionally on the circuit, but I use airsoft guns extensively at home in my training, both with some little targets that I have set up as well as some close range stuff. For example, you know, a lot of people that carry a handgun, concealed carry holders, think that the gun solution is the only solution. Well, I do a lot of combatives and drawing and close range stuff and learning how to integrate those close range items and techniques with my airsoft gun because it's completely safe. Mm-hmm. You know, I put the protective gear on and stuff like that. I'm not gonna practice that dynamic stuff live fire because there's that risk. And that's someone could do at home, and you know, and there's no real safety risk. As long as
I'm pretty sure if you've got a gun tucked in this region, you wanna make sure you know what you're doing before you start pouring out live rounds, am I right?
Absolutely, man. Yeah, you wanna go through some safety checks first. So yeah, you can, you know, from the basic, the beginners to the advanced folks, there's always something that you can do with an airsoft or, you know, some sort of air gun.